Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. All right, in this video, we're going to look at inserting images into Word. We'll also look at some slightly more advanced stuff. So we'll look at just putting in a nice basic logo in here. We'll also look at, say, an image like this where he has the ability to kind of move around wherever he likes, okay, and not be kind of like stuck down into the text. So let's go and do that in Microsoft Word. All right, to insert an image anywhere in your document, okay, we're going to have your cursor flashing where you want it to go. So I'm going to put a return in just above my text. I'm going to move my cursor up. So there he is flashing. Then I'm going to go to my insert panel, and I'm going to go along to the one that says pictures. Click on pictures. Okay, and it's going to open up my browser, and I'm going to go and find it. If you know what it's called, you can just type in search here. Now, by default, it jumps into pictures and see if it can find it in here. If yours is in here, job done. Okay, if it's somewhere else in the document, okay, I know that mine's on my desktop, okay, I know mine's in the Word exercise files, and there's the logos that I've got. Now, if you've got a logo and you know it's in there, okay, but you can't see it, it's probably because it's a format that Word can't use. You can't use things like EPSs and AI files and PSDs. Okay, so if it's there, you know it's there, but you can't see it, it's probably a format you can't use. To know it's there, go to all pictures, go to all files, and these are all the files that are in here, but what Word does is it just cuts it down to pictures that you can use. Thank you, Word. Okay, I'm going to use the Bring Your Laptop logo in here. I'm going to click Insert. Okay, and it's brought it in at an appropriate size, which is great. If yours comes in at ginormous size, okay, you might have to grab the corners and shrink it down. Okay, to shrink it down, don't use these edge ones. So if I use this edge one, look, I can shrink it down. Okay, but it kind of squishes it. Okay, so what you need to do is just use any of these corners. Doesn't matter which one you use. Okay, there's ones over here, these ones. Okay, I can just grab the corner and I kind of have to drag it in at an angle. It's a bit weird. I understand. Okay, but you can drag it. If it flips upside down, give your mouse a wiggle until it gets up the right way. Okay, if you're finding it really hard to resize, you can say up the top here, there's a height and a width. Okay, so we're at format. Okay, we've clicked on an image, we're at format, and over here we've got height and width. So you might decide, actually, I'm just gonna shrink this down to say 2 inches, and it's more of an appropriate size in there now. So that's putting an image just kind of normally. It's not very exciting. And he kind of moves along with the box that he's inside. But what I'd like to do now is insert an image and let him be like a lone wolf to kind of be able to roam around the page wherever he likes. Because by default, if I put in an image, let's say put an image at the end of this paragraph here, I'm going to put him in, insert image, use a random image just for an example. That's him. You'll notice that he goes up and down depending on where the type is. Okay, which is kind of cool. What I'd like to do is, with him selected, I want to kind of like just drag him so he's kind of hanging off the edge here rather than tucked in by the margins. To do it, select on the image. There's this little option in here, and it says the one I want is this one here, text behind. Okay, and or it could be in front, it doesn't matter. Either of these two options are going to give us the desired result. Watch this. Okay, so the text kind of like flows over top of it, or you can have it in front of it. But what happens is, if I grab the edge now, can you see? He's this kind of like dude that I can move around and do whatever I want with. Okay, so and that's how you kind of like detach him from being stuck in the text. You need to keep an eye out on this anchor, okay, still, because if I delete this anchor, the image is going to delete. So we need somewhere in the document to be held onto. So that's how to get an image to detach from the text and yeah, get him to move around by himself. All right, that's it for this video. Let's get on to the next one. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.